Hi friends, welcome in this lecture. In this lecture, we'll talk about the fire burn areas and how we can study this problem with the help of remote sensing technique and more specifically with the help of Google Earth Engine. So I'm using here fire burn area, which includes all types of burning, but this burning is associated with the larger areas. And you know, it's important to analyze this problem, not only spatial but temporal also. You have to study that the frequency of burning, is it increasing or stable or decreasing. So as in general, due to the climate change, the scientist says that this burning activity is more frequent than before. So this you have to focus. And the second thing you have to focus in the spatial analysis. In a spatial analysis, you have to see that how much area has been burned and what is its impact on the ecosystem. So you have to study temporal as well as spatial. Down is something about me. I'm Dr. Zubair Islam, working in the Department of Geography, Adigrat University. So before we start practicing, let's discuss these are the two terms very important related to the burn areas study. One is fire intensity, another is burn severity. So fire intensity, you know, it represents the energy that is released from the organic matter during the burning process. And it also refers to the intensity of the fire while it is active. And on the other hand, burn severity, it describes how the fire intensity affects the functioning of the ecosystem. So here down is the image. You can see left hand side, it is showing the fire intensity, and the right hand side, it shows the burn severity. So burn severity within a region, it may vary. It depends on the ecosystem. It varies from one ecosystem to the another ecosystem. So burn severity is important from the viewpoint of, you know, if a barren area with a small grass is burned, it will not be as much severe as the area where there are long trees. So the burn severity, of course, it will be more in the more vegetated areas. So as you know, in remote sensing, we use the indexes to study different phenomena. As we are studying normalized difference of vegetation index to study the vegetation. Similarly, we study the burn areas with the help of normalized burn ratio, that is in short known as NBR. The normalized burn ratio is an index. It is designed to highlight the burn areas in large fire zones. And here you can see this is the plot, and the horizontal scale shows the electromagnetic spectrum. On the other hand, the vertical scale shows the reflectance values in percentage. The green line shows the healthy vegetation. On the other hand, the red line shows the burned areas. There are two differences at the peak. One is in the near infrared side and another is in the short wave infrared side. This is the reason we are taking this NIR and SWIR to study the burn areas. And the formula is here, NIR minus SWIR divided by NIR plus SWIR. Here you can understand that in the near infrared side, the healthy vegetation is at the peak and it is above 40% the reflectance. Why? Because this is the characteristics of the leaf, that when the energy interacts with the leaf, it reflects in higher amount, in higher percentages. The chlorophyll reflects higher near infrared parts, while from the fire, from the burn areas, you know, when the leaves will be destroyed, then this reflectance, of course, it will come down. And just opposite to it, if you will go to the short infrared part, in the short infrared part, leaves does not reflect much more this short wave infrared part is not reflected higher, more in the healthy vegetation. But once it is burned, then naturally the short wave infrared part will start reflecting higher, means above 40 or 45%. So these are the two differences. With the help of this index, we can study the normalized burn ratio. So here we can associate this NBR with the very important aspect of our study, that is burn severity. So burn severity is nothing but a difference of NBR, pre-fire NBR minus post-fire NBR. And the resultant values are here. If this delta NBR range, if it ranges from 0.660 to plus 1.300, then this is the higher severity. And what does it mean? Means the vegetation has got, you know, very it has got lost, too much lost of the vegetation. And as you can see here, DNBR ranges are given. You just pause it and you have to think of it, that why these values are coming. And why these values are coming? Because of the loss of the vegetation. Here, if you want to study the burn severity, then you have to use this one. So in the next part, we will take the Google Earth engine and we will practice it. So here is a simple code for fire intensity, and the data which we are using is FIRMS here. What is FIRMS? Just you copy it and paste in the dataset part, you will find FIRMS data. And here this is FIRMS. If you want to know more about this data, you just click here and you will find the details. The description is here, the Earth Engine version of the Fire Information for Resource Management System. It contains, you know, it contains the Lens fire detection product in the rasterized form. So what are the data bands available for that? Here, band T21, it's a brightness temperature of the of a fire pixel using the MODIS channel. So the units are in Kelvin here. Okay, and the resolution is 1000 meter. So just we will run it, we'll see the result. So here the minimum brightness temperature is given in the Kelvin. Minimum is 325 and maximum is 400. You can convert into Celsius also. Palettes are given here, red, orange, yellow. The yellow part will be showing the high intensity of fire burning, while the red areas will show the less intensity. So here the values are only 2018. The month is 8th, that is I think July, August, yeah. So only for 10 days here. This is only for 10 days. The same if you want for 2019, just you have to change it 2019. And let's see in 2019. So the result will show you 2019 result. So here there is very less burning in 2019 in some part of the southern Ethiopia here, 2019. Shows the burning areas. Let's see in for whole year 2019 1 to 12. Let's see it here. This is for whole year, and of course in 1 year there are many areas burn. So the yellow part is showing you the high intensity and the red part is showing you lesser intensity. And if there is some orange color, you can detect it. So that is in middle of the low to higher intensity part. this is the way we can see that which areas are burned. Okay. So with the help of the same data, you can study the temporal analysis also, that during 2000 how much area was burned. Again, 2002, 3, 4, 5, the burning area is increasing, or is it stable, or it is increasing. In general, it is said that it is increasing because of the climate change. So here we can go for intensity. In another code, we will see that in which day burning was there, means which day of the year burning took place. So to know the burn date, this is the code, and both the codes will be available to you for your practice, and it will be given in the description box. This is the data I'm using for the burning date here. I just copy it and I will see about it what this data is. I will see its description and bends. And this is the description. You can study the spatial resolution is 250 meter. And the bends which are given here, this is burn date, confidence level, and land cover. Very important data. If you wanna study the land cover, then instead of the burn date, you can choose the land cover. It will help you parallelly that which land cover was burned. And okay. So let's see. I will run it and I will see. So filter date is here, given 2019 January to 2019 December, and total, this is a year, and year is divided into 365 days. So minimum value is 1 and maximum is 366. If a pixel value is giving you, suppose 1, so what is this? It's a January 1st burning. Okay, and now let's see, these are the palettes which will help us in the visualization. So if you want different time, then you can change it here. Let's see, 20 and 20, because 2020 is still is 20 is going on. So we can change it to the better to take a year here for demonstration, because I have to change the maximum minimum value also. Then 1919, okay, fine. Then run it, already run it. So if you will see the area which is burned, is forested area, of course, and non-forested areas also. So if we will see the pixel value for this burn area, here the confidence is 99%, you are confident it was burned, and it's 66. 66 means what? 31 for January, February 31 plus 28, around how much, 60, yeah, and 6 March. So this 66 months, 66 means around 6 March, okay, burn date was, means 6 March was the burn date here. And how much confident you are? 99% confident for this. So you can analyze here. Another areas also. Sometimes burning take place in the agriculture fields also. You can see here when there is a large agriculture areas burned, and this is you know, in the newspapers you see the publications that okay, during this time more burning is taking place in Haryana or Punjab or Western Uttar Pradesh, because this is man-made burning here, and you can see the burning near New Delhi is being taken place. This area, you will click here, and the similar color shows that when the crop is completed, then the residuals are burned by the farmer. So this is 129. 129 means this is around April, end of the March and beginning of the April. So end of the March and beginning of the April, what crop is, or so this is the way we can study the from the viewpoint of burn date. Here you can move your map, and you can study you know, the different parts of the world where burning is taking more place and what is the reason for that. So this was all about the burn date and the confidence level of burn date. So it's enough for now. Thanks for listening and watching. See you in another video tutorial.